Dave Thomas.
Oh, hello. I'm Ed Grimley. And welcome to the fourth in our series of lectures on reptiles. Today we'll be talking about the snake. It's like we'll be talking about the snake, you know. The snake is a very long animal. And even though he doesn't have any ears, he can hear quite well, which I find quite interesting, I must say. You would think that if he didn't have ears, that would be it for hearing, but the tricky snake fools you once again. Yes, it can be a hard cookie to figure out the snake, and that's no lie. There are many stories in mythology about the snake. Some of them are certainly true, but then others you hear, you just say to yourself, oh, I doubt that very much, I must say, a doubter. It's like the average person thinks that the snake is real slimy and slippery, like a grease ball. Well, no way. The snake is as dry as toast, unless it's been in the water, and then it's slippery and slimy, I suppose. So maybe the average person is right. I don't know. It's difficult to say. Anthropologists say that snakes are carnivorous. Okay, fine, but what kind of food does the snake eat? Like, also, people will come up to me and say, Ed, is a snake the devil? Is he a devil? Well, a lot of people wonder that, a lot of island people. Well, I don't think so. To me, if that isn't a bunch of baloney, why did I just bring two pieces of bread for lunch? The main thing about the snake is not to act scared. You shouldn't act scared, you know. So today we're going to look at a live cobra. And maybe some of the pieces of the puzzle we call snake will just, they'll be okay. Let's bring them out and take a look. Might be a little shy of the lights. The main secret here is to use your own intellect so you won't fall into the snake's hypnotic stare. Yes, master.